question given here is, two trains, one starts from Bombay with a speed of 60, sorry, one starts from Bombay with a speed of 120 kilometers per hour at 6 o'clock. Same time at 6 o'clock, a train starts from Pune with a speed of 80 kilometers per hour. When will the two things meet? When the two trains will meet? Well, let's see where all they meet here in between. When they meet, if this train has traveled X, the total distance given is 800 kilometers. So if this has traveled X, this would have traveled 800 minus X. So distance traveled together by the two trains will be 800 kilometers. X plus 800 minus X, total 800. Now simply, let's say the two trains meet T hours after they started. So in T hours, this train will travel 120T. In T hours, this train will travel 80T. So this distance 120T plus this distance 80T, total distance is 800. 200T is equal to 800. T is 4 hours. Simply, two stations 800 kilometers apart, Bombay and Pune. A train starts from Bombay at 6 o'clock with speed 120, other starts from Pune at 6 o'clock with speed 80. Now, at what time the two trains will meet? Now, whenever they meet, if first train, it's at this point they meet. So if this train has traveled X, this would have traveled 800 minus X. So distance traveled by this train plus this train together. So the basic concept is, when the two trains are traveling in the opposite direction, whenever they meet, total distance traveled is nothing but the distance between the stations. This has traveled 120T. Let's say after T hours they meet. So in T hours 120T. In T hours, this has done 80T, total distance 800. So after 4 hours, the two trains will meet 4 hours. Now, if the question is at what distance from Bombay will they meet? Speed 120 into time 4. So when they meet, the distance from Bombay is 480 kilometers. At what distance from Pune will they meet? Speed into time 320. 320 kilometers from Pune and 480 kilometers from Bombay they will meet. Now the smarter way was, the distance between the two stations is 800 kilometers. The Bombay train starts at 6 o'clock with speed 120. The Pune train starts at 6 o'clock, same time with speed 80. The basic thing is, if they have started at same time, when they meet, both of them have traveled for same time. So after how much time the two trains will meet? Whenever they meet, distance traveled by this train plus distance traveled by this train, total distance is 800. In 1 hour, this train goes 120. This train goes 80. So together per hour, this goes 120, this goes 80. So together in 1 hour, they travel 200. Whenever they meet, if this has done X, this would have done 800 minus X. Together they have to travel 800 kilometers per hour, 120, 80 per hour, 200. So 4 hours they will need to travel when they meet. Simply, if starting time is same, before meeting both of them have traveled same time. How much time? they will be required to travel. Total distance when they meet, if this has done x, this has done 800 minus x, total distance they have to cover 800. Per hour this goes 120, this goes 80, so together per hour they do 200. So after 4 hours the two trains will meet. After 4 hours, so in 4 hours first train will do 120 into 4, that is 480. So when they meet, it's 480 kilometers from Bombay, and from this side 320 kilometers from Pune. 320 from Pune and 480 from Bombay. At what distance? Speed from Bombay 120, 4 hours. So at 480 kilometers from Bombay and at 320 kilometers from Pune, they will meet. Now the question given here is, two stations, Bombay and Pune, they are 640 kilometers apart. Train started from Bombay at 6 in the morning with speed 90. Another train started from Pune at the same time with speed 60. So obviously when they meet, total distance traveled will be 640. Last time, if Bombay train has done x, Pune train would have done 640 minus x. Together they would have done x plus 640 minus x, total 640. Per hour this side train goes 90, this goes 60, so total 640 upon 150. That is 4 hours and 4 by 15 hours. That is 4 hours and 16 minutes. 6 o'clock they start. Now simply, 6 o'clock they start. One train starts with speed 90, other with 60. Total distance 640. So whenever they meet, total distance traveled should be 640. Per hour 90 plus 60, 150. So time needed is going to be 64 by 15. That is 4 hours and 4 by 15 hours. That is 4 hours and 60 minutes. So at what time will the two trains meet? After 6 o'clock, 4 hours 16 minutes, that is 10:16 they will meet. Now at what distance from Bombay will they meet? Bombay's train speed is 90, but when they meet, time needed is 64 by 15 hours. So in that much time, distance done is 384. Pune train speed is 60, after this much time they meet, so distance done is. So at what distance from Pune will they meet? 256 kilometers. And at what distance from Bombay will they meet? 380. A quick recap. Total distance 640, total speed 150. So time needed 4 hours and 4 by 15 hours, that's how we get it. 4 hours 16 minutes, at 10:16 they will meet. At what distance from Bombay? Bombay train speed is this into time, so we get distance. So at 384 kilometers from Bombay they will meet. At what distance from Pune? Train speed 60, time this. So at 256 kilometers from Pune they will meet. The question given here is, two stations, Bombay and Pune. The distance is 1000 kilometers. One train starts at 6 o'clock with speed 60. other train starts at 7 o'clock with speed 90. Okay, now, before we proceed with the question, let's check out a simple thing. Now, let's see. If one person, a person A starts from X towards Y at 6 o'clock and other person starts, B starts from Y towards X at 8 o'clock, whenever they meet, let's say if they meet at 12 o'clock, this has traveled for 6 hours, this has traveled for 4 hours. The difference is always going to be of 2 hours because starting time for A was 6, B was 8. Meeting time is same always, but if starting time difference is 2 hours, traveling time difference is also going to be 2 hours. If starting time difference is 2, traveling time difference is also 2 hours. So now, whenever they meet here in between, because this started at 6 and this started at 7, if this train has traveled for T hours when they meet, the other train would have traveled for T minus 1 hours, because starting time difference is of 1 hour. This is at 6, this is at 7. So whenever they meet, if this train has traveled for T, this would have traveled for T hours. But in any case, we know whenever the two trains meet, total distance this plus this should be 1000. So first train by that time would have traveled 60 t, speed into time. Other train would have traveled 90 into t minus 1, speed into time. 60 t plus 90 t, 150 t equal to 1090. T is 109 upon 15, 7 hours and 4 by 15 hours. 7 hours and 4 by 15 hours. That is 7 hours 16 minutes. But this is the time after 6 o'clock. So after 6, they need 7 hours and 16 minutes. That is 13:16. That is afternoon 1:16. Just quick check. Bombay and Pune, two stations, 1000 kilometers. Bombay train starts at 6 o'clock with speed 60. Pune train starts at 7 o'clock with speed 90. Starting time, there is a difference of 1 hour. So before meeting, if for this Bombay train has traveled for T hours, the Pune train would have traveled for T minus 1. So when they meet, the Bombay train would have done speed into time 60 t. Pune train would have done speed into time this thing, total distance. So we get 7 hours and 16 minutes. But this is the time T after 6 o'clock. After 6, these many hours. So at this time, 1:16. Let's look at a smarter way. The smarter way is going to be, and that's what we are supposed to use. A train starts from Bombay at 6 o'clock with speed 60. A train from Pune starts at 7 o'clock with speed 90. When the Pune train starts, the Bombay train already has traveled up to 7 o'clock. The Bombay train has already traveled up to 7 o'clock. 6 to 7, 1 hour with speed 60. So it has already done 60 kilometers. Repeat. When the Pune train started at 7 o'clock, Bombay train had started at 6 o'clock. So 6 to 7, only Bombay train was going. So 6 to 7, in 1 hour it has already done 60. Now this also continues with speed 60, this has also started with speed 90, and the remaining distance out of 1000, 60 gone. So now the time needed, total distance 940, together they have to go, per hour 60 plus 90. That is 6 hours and 4 by 15 hours. That is 6 hours and 16 minutes. The question is, Bombay train started at 6 o'clock with speed 60. Pune train started at 7 o'clock, smarter way, that's what we're looking at. So whenever the second, the later on train starts till 7 o'clock, this train has already done speed into time for 1 hour 60. Now at 7 o'clock, this continues, out of 1000, 60 is already done, remaining 940. So the two trains together have to cover 940. Per hour, this train will go 60, this train will go 90. So time needed is 6 hours, 60 minutes, 16 minutes. But this is the time after 7 o'clock. After 7, 6, 16. So at what time will they meet? 1:16. These many hours after 7. Now at what distance from Bombay will they meet? Distance from Bombay when they meet. Already up to 7 o'clock, it has done 60, 6 to 7, and after that, speed into time, time is 94 by 15. So that is 60 plus this, so that is 60. Plus 15 forza, so that is 376. At what distance from Bombay will they meet? 60 plus speed into time, so that is going to be 436. At what distance from Pune will they meet? Speed 90 into time. This is the distance from Pune. Quick recap. At what distance from Bombay will they meet? The train from 6 to 7 already has done 60 kilometers. After that, it needs 94 by 15 hours. Speed is 60. So, 60 plus 376. This much distance from Bombay they will meet. And at what distance from Pune? Speed 90 into time. Now the question here is, two stations, Bombay and Pune, the distance is 6:30. Bombay train starts at 6:45 with speed 100. Pune train starts with at 8:15 with speed 60. What first we do is 6:45 to 8:15 till this train started, how much distance Bombay train has done? 6:30 to 8:15, what is the time? 6:45 it started. 6:45 to 7 o'clock, 15 minutes. 7 to 8, it's 1 hour. And 8 to 8:15, it's 15 minutes. So 6:45 to 8:15, the time is 1 hour and 30 minutes. Minutes to us, that is 30 by 60 hours. That is 1 and half hour. So 1 and a half hour only this train was going. So in 1.5 hour, already it has done 150. Now at 8:15, this train starts with speed 100. It continues. And this also is continuing, means it's starting with speed 60. Out of 6:30, already 150 is done. So remaining distance now is 480. So how much time will they need? Total distance 480, per hour together 160. Time needed is going to be 3 hours. 3 hours after 8, so what time? 11:50. Quick recap what we did. A train from Bombay started at 6:45 with speed 100. Another train from Pune started at 8:15 with speed 60. First thing what we do, if starting times are not same, when the second train starts, till that time first train has done how much? 6:45 to 8:50. 6:45 to 7, 15 minutes. 7 to 8, 1 hour. The way you want to calculate, it's 1 hour and 30 minutes, that is 1.5 hour. So in 1.5 hour, speed into time, Bombay train has already done 150. So now 8:15, already 150 is done. Out of 6:30, 150 done, remaining 480. This train continues with speed 100. This train starts with 60. Together they have to go 480. Together per hour they do 160. So in how many hours will they meet? 3 hours after 8:15. So at 11:15 they will. Now the question here is, this train started at 6:45, this at 8:15, till 8:15 in 1.5 hour it had done 150, both continued speeds 100 and 60, together they have to do 480, together speed 160, so 3 hours. At 11:15 they meet. Now at what distance from Bombay will they meet? Distance from Bombay. Already up to 8:15 this had done 150, plus now for 3 hours it will go with speed 100, so that is 150 plus 300, that is 450. Already done 150. In 3 hours it will do 300, 450. And at what distance from Pune? Distance from Pune when they meet? 3 hours with speed 60. Speed 60 into time 3 hours. So at what distance from Pune will they meet? 180. Up to 8:15, Bombay train has already gone for 1.5 hour, 150. After that, both of them travel for 3 hours. So in 3 hours, this train will go 300. So at what distance? 450 from Bombay. 450 from Bombay. Distance from Pune? 3 hours with speed 60. So distance from Pune will be 180. The question here is, two stations, 2400 kilometers apart. Now, train X starts with a speed 200. Train Y starts with a speed 400. At the same time, a bird starts with speed 1200. Now, obviously, the two trains will meet after total distance 2400. Total speed 200 plus 400, so that is 4 hours. The two trains will meet after 4 hours. But obviously, first bird is going to meet the train Y. Now after how much time, bird and train Y are going to meet? Bird speed 1200, Y speed 400. Whenever they meet, total distance will be 2400, Bird speed 1200, train speed. So total distance upon total speed. After 3 by 2 hours they will meet, that is 1.5 hours, 1 hour 30 minutes. So whenever they meet after 3 by 2 hours or 1.5 hours, in that much time bird will travel 1800, this train would have traveled 600. Bird would have traveled 1200 into 1.5, 1800. Train Y would have traveled 400 into 1.5, 600. Quick repeat. Train X starts with speed 200. Train Y starts with speed 400. Total distance 2400. After how much time the two trains will meet? Total distance upon total speed. But before the two trains meet, first, because bird is much faster, bird is going to meet the train Y. Bird starts with speed 1200, train Y starts with speed 400. So whenever they meet, total distance 2400. Per hour speed 1200 plus 400. So they will be required to travel for 3 by 2 hours, that is 1.5 hours. In 1.5 hours, bird will travel speed into time 1800. And in 1.5 hour, train Y will travel 600. Now, up till now we have got, in 1.5 hour, bird has already reached 1800. Train Y has already reached 600. Y has come here, it's continuing. Bird has met train Y. And in 1.5 hours, this train also, it was not idle. So this train, it started, train X started with speed 200. For 1.5 hour, it has done 300. So now, train X continues with speed 200. Train Y continues with 400. And bird turns back with speed 1200. The moment it meets Y, it turns back. So now what we know? The remaining distance is 1500. Out of 1800, bird had traveled, it turned back. But till the time bird met train Y, train X has traveled for the same time 1.5 into 200, 300. Remaining distance 1500. Train X continues with speed 200. Train Y continues with speed 1200. So whenever they, not the train Y, I'm so sorry, bird continues with speed 1200. Now when the bird and train X meet, total distance will be 1500. Together their speed is 1400. So time needed is 15 by 14 hours. So in that much time, bird will travel speed into time 18,000 upon 14. 14 ones are 14, 14 twos are 28, 14 eights are, 14 fives are 70, roughly 1285 kilometers. So when they meet, bird would have traveled for 1285 kilometers. And in the same time, train X would have traveled. So now, when bird meets train X for the first time after start, first, it has traveled 1800 kilometers to meet Y. It turns back. Now to meet X, it goes nearly 1285 kilometers. That is 3085. Question is, up till now, what we did? Train X starts with speed 200. Same time opposite direction Y starts with speed 400. Same time bird starts with speed 1200. We know the two trains will meet after 4 hours. But after how much time bird will meet train Y for the first time? Whenever bird meets train Y, total distance is going to be 2400. Per hour they do 600, 1600. So time is 1.5 hours. So when bird meets train Y for the first time, distance traveled is 1800 after 1.5 hours. The moment it meets train Y, it turns back. But in the same time, when after in 1.5 hour, bird had traveled 1800. The moment it meets Y, it turns back with speed 12. In that much time, train Y had done 600, speed 400 into 1.5 hours 600. And in the same time, train X would have done speed into time 300. Now, train X continues from here on with speed 200. Bird turns back and continues with speed 1200. So when X and bird are going to meet, total remaining distance in between is 1500, 1800 minus 300. Together per hour they go 1400. So time needed will be 15 by 14 hours. So in this much time, bird will travel how much? Speed into time, distance 1285. So the distance traveled by bird before meeting train X for the first time after start, till the time it met train Y, distance was 1800. After meeting Y, it turned back and the distance traveled is 1285. So total distance when it meets train X for the first time after start is 3085 kilometers. The most commonly asked question is the distance traveled by the bird in the whole journey. Question is, train X starts with speed 200, bird starts with speed 1200, same time train Y starts with speed 400. Bird is faster than the train X. The moment bird meets train Y here, bird turns back. The moment it meets X, it turns back, and finally, when the bird stops, bird will stop only when two trains meet. So the whole journey, bird will continue to travel till the time two trains meet. And we know total distance this. Two trains are going to meet after distance upon speed. So bird will continue to shuttle between the two trains for 4 hours. Continuously bird will travel till the time two trains meet. Two trains meet after 4 hours. So distance traveled by bird in the whole journey, 4 hours into speed 1200. So bird will travel 4800 kilometers before being crushed. Bird will travel 4800 kilometers before being crushed. This is the most commonly asked question. Question is, bird starts with speed 1200, train X starts with speed 200, train Y starts with speed 400. The moment bird meets train Y, it turns back, continues to do so, and bird will stop only when the two trains meet. And the two trains will meet when the total distance upon total speed, 4 hours. So bird will also continuously travel for 4 hours. Speed of bird is 1200. So before being crushed, total distance traveled by bird will be 4800 kilometers. Part A. Part B and C we have already done. Distance traveled by bird when it meets train X for the first time, sorry, train Y for the first time. When it meets train Y for the first time, total distance upon total speed, 3/2 hours. In 1.5 hour, it would have done 1800. Now, after 1.5 hour, it has already done 1800. Bird turns back with speed 1200. In 1.5 hour, train X has already done 300. Train X continues with speed 200. Bird turns back with speed 1200. This remaining distance, now when they meet, is 1500. So the bird and train X will meet after 15 by 14 hours. So in this much time, bird will travel this much distance. So distance traveled by bird, when it meets train X for the first time after start, first 1800 till the time it met Y, plus this thing. Part C is answer. The most commonly asked question is part A. Distance traveled by the bird in the whole journey. Simple logic. Bird continues to shuttle between the two trains till the time two trains meet. The two trains meet after 4 hours. So bird will also continuously travel for 4 hours. So in 4 hours, the distance traveled by bird will be 4800 kilometers. The question given here is, a train starts from Pune at 6 o'clock and reaches Nagpur at 9 a.m. And the train starts from Nagpur at 7 a.m. and reaches Pune at 9 a.m. So as we know, Pune to Nagpur and Nagpur to Pune, distance is same. So if distance is same, speed and time are inversely proportional. If one increases, other decreases. So the train from Pune to Nagpur needs 3 hours. Pune to Nagpur, while Nagpur to Pune train needs 2 hours. This is the actual time. As we know, speed is inversely proportional to time. Say Pune-Nagpur train needs 3 and Nagpur-Pune train needs 2. Speed ratio is 2:3. This is the ratio. So let's say we say speeds 2x km per hour, 3x. Quick check. Pune to Nagpur train needs 3 hours. Nagpur to Pune train needs 2 hours. Same distance. So speed and time are inversely proportional. So now, if time is 3 hours and 2 hours, speed ratio is 2:3. So how we get distance? The train which is having speed 2x needs 3 hours. So speed into time, distance 6x. The train which needs 2 hours, speed is 3x, distance 6x. So now the question has become much more simpler here. Pune to Nagpur, we know distance 6x. What we got? This train starts at 6 o'clock with speed 2x. This train starts at 7 o'clock with speed 3x. And the total distance is 6x. How did we get it? Quick check here. How did we get it? A train started from Pune at 6 and reached Nagpur at 9. So time needed 3 hours. The other train started from Nagpur at 7. Reach Pune at 9, 2 hours. Same distance, speed is inversely proportional to time. Time ratio 3:2, so speed ratio 2:3. 2x, 3x. 3 hours into 2x, distance 6. 2 hours into 3x, distance 6. So what we have got? One train starts at 6 o'clock with speed 2x. Other starts at 7 o'clock with speed 3x, distance 6x. So according to our normal approach, reaching time uses over till 7 o'clock. For 1 hour, this train has already covered speed into time 2x. So now this remaining distance is 4x. This train continues with speed 2x. This starts with speed 3x. Remaining distance 4x. Upon combined speed 5x. So time needed 4 by 5 hours, that is 48 minutes. So this is the time after 7 o'clock. So 7:48, the two trains will meet. Quick check. 6 o'clock, this train starts with speed 2x. 7 o'clock, this train starts with speed 3x. Reaching time, use over, and distance we got 6x. Just previously we have seen total distance 6x. 6 to 7, only this train was going for 1 hour into speed 2x, distance is 2x, so this remaining distance now is 4x. This train continues 7 o'clock with speed 2x, this train starts with speed 3x. Now together when they meet, they have to travel 4x, combined speed is 2x plus 3x together 5x, 4 by 5 hours, that is 48 minutes. 48 minutes after 7, 7:48, they are going to meet. Quick recall. One train starts at 6 o'clock, reaches at 9. Other train, opposite direction, starts at 7, reaches 9. The reaching time uses just to get the time. Pune to Nagpur 3 hours, Nagpur to Pune 2 hours. Speed ratio 2 is to 3, 2x, 3x. So we get speed into time distance, 6x. 6x distance, this starts at 6 o'clock with speed 2x, 7 o'clock with speed 3x. 6 to 7 in 1 hour, 2x is already done. So out of 6x, 2x is done, remaining 4x. Together per hour, 5x, 48 minutes after 7. The question given here is, a train started from Pune at 6 o'clock and reaches Nagpur at 10 o'clock. While a train starts from Nagpur at 7 o'clock and reaches Pune at 10:30. So what all we know is Pune to Nagpur train needs 4 hours, Nagpur to Pune train needs 3.5 hours. This is the time ratio, this is actual time, we are not supposed to mess up with that. 4 hours, 3.5, time 4 is to 3.5, I cannot change it to 7, 8 is to 7, as time is actual time. So now speed ratio is inverse, Pune to Nagpur, Nagpur to Pune, same distance. So speed ratio 3.5x, 4x. So how we get distance? Now speed is the ratio, so 3.5 is to 4. We can make it as 7 is to 8, it's right, because finally it's ratio. Time is actual, so we cannot do it, this is wrong. Speed is ratio, so we can do it, this is right. But let's keep it as it is. Pune to Nagpur, 6 o'clock it starts, reaches at 10, 4 hours. Nagpur to Pune, 7 to 10:30, 3.5. Speed is inverse of time, 3.5 is to 4. So distance we get 14x, 14x. So Pune to Nagpur, distance we know is 14x. So simply what we know, 6 o'clock, this train starts with speed 3.5x. 7 o'clock, this train starts with speed 4x. Quick recall, a train started at 6. Reached at 10, 4 hours. Nagpur train started at 7, reached at 10:30, 3.5. Time is actual, so 4 is to 3.5, I cannot make 8 is to 7. Speed is inverse of time as the distance is same, 3.5x is to 4x. This can be made as 7 is to 8, but we'll keep it as it is. How to get Pune Nagpur distance? 4 hours time, speed 3.5x, distance 14x. 3.5 hours time, 4x speed 14x. Speed into time. So now let's try to solve the question here. First we found out the ratio of speeds. 6 o'clock this train starts with speed 3.5x. 7 o'clock this train starts with speed 4x. 6 to 7 only this train was going, so in 1 hour it has already done 3.5x. Total this distance was 14x. 3.5 is already done, So remaining distance is 10.5x. 7 o'clock, it continues with speed 3.5x. This starts with speed 4x. So what is the time needed? 10.5x distance upon speed 3.5 plus 4, 7.5. So 105 upon 75. 7 by 5 hours, that is 1 hour and 2 fifth of an hour. 1 hour and 24 minutes. Or we can say 7 by 5 hours is 1.4 hour, that is 1.4 into 60, 84 minutes. 1 hour 24 minutes is after 7 o'clock. So at what time will they meet 8:24? Quick check up till now what we did. Train started at 6 o'clock, reached Nagpur at 10 o'clock, 4 hours. Train from Nagpur had started at 7 o'clock, reached Pune at 10:30, 3.5 hours, 30 minutes is half hour. Speed and time are inverse of each other, distance same, so speed ratio 3.5 is to 4. Pune to Nagpur, time into speed distance 14x. Now we know distance is 14x, this starts at 6 o'clock with speed 3.5, it starts at 7 with speed 4. We know total distance 14x. This train starts at 6 o'clock with speed 3.5x. This starts at 7 o'clock with speed 4x. 6 to 7, only first train goes for 1 hour, 3.5x. Remaining distance, per hour this goes, per hour this goes. Total distance upon total speed. So we get 7 by 5 hours, that is 1 hour, 24 minutes. 1 hour 24 minutes after 7 o'clock. So at what time will they meet? 8:24. Now let's work out certain things. Now simply, let's say Aishwarya starts from Pune towards Bombay at 6 o'clock. And Salman starts from Bombay towards Pune at 6 o'clock. So whenever they meet in between, let's say at 8 o'clock they meet at Lonavala, time travelled by each of them will be same. So if starting time is same before meeting, time travel is same. How do we use it? First, we are trying to derive here. Let's say one train starts at with speed S1 and same time other train starts with speed S2 in the opposite direction. We have given starting time is same. So obviously they will meet in between somewhere. Now let's say they meet after T hours. After T hours they meet. So this distance is S1T. And this distance is S2T. Before meeting, it has travelled for T hours. This has also travelled for T hours. If starting time is same, before meeting, same. So let's say in T hours, this has done S1T and this has done S2T. Now let's say after meeting, first train needs T1 hours to reach the destination and second train needs T2 hours to reach the destination. So after meeting, first train needs T1 hours, but it has to travel distance S2T and its speed is S1. And after meeting, second train, time needed is T2. It has to travel S1T and its speed is S2. If I divide the two times, T2 upon T1,
is S1T upon S2 and this is S2T upon S1. So this implies T2 upon T1 is S1 square upon S2 square. So we get S1 by S2 under root of T2 by T. What all we have seen up till now? Let's quick recap. First thing what we saw is if two things start at same time in opposite direction and they meet at any time before meeting, both the times are same. Time travel is same. How do we use it? Let's say two trains are going in opposite direction, speed S1 and S2. They start at the same time. So obviously before meeting, time travel is same. Let's say they meet after TR somewhere here. So this distance is S1T and this distance is S2T. Now after meeting, to reach the destination, let's say they are going from A to B and B to A. So for first train to reach B, time needed after meeting is T1, and for second train after meeting to reach A, time needed is T2. How do we get any time? First train has to go this distance S2T with speed S1. So time is T1 is S2T upon S1. Second train has to go S1T with speed S2. So time T2. So if we divide the two times, T2 is S1T upon S2, T1 is S2T upon S1, so we get S1 by S2. So very important concept what we said here, important derivation. If two things are going in the opposite direction, they start at same time, and after meeting, first train needs T1 hours and second train needs T2 hours to reach destination. After meeting, first train needs T1, second train needs T2. So in that case, ratio of speed is under root of inverse. Two trains going in the opposite direction, starting time same, means before meeting same time, and after meeting T1 and T2, so ratio of speed is under root of inverse of the time. Now the question given here is, a train starts from Pune towards Bombay, and same time a train starts from Bombay towards Pune. Same time they started, so they cross in between sometime. After meeting, first train needs 4 hours to reach the destination, and after meeting, second train needs 9 hours to reach the destination. Let's say Pune to Bombay train speed S1, Bombay to Pune train speed S2. Now just now we have seen, if before meeting same time, after meeting T1 and T2, ratio of speed is under root of inverse of time. So S1 by S2 is under root of T2 by T1. Just putting the values, 9:4. So what all we get here is S1 by S2 is 3:2. What we saw, a train starts from Pune towards Bombay with speed S1. Same time, a train starts from Bombay towards Pune, speed S2. So before meeting, they have traveled for same time. After meeting, first train needs 4 hours and second train needs 9 hours. We know two things going in the opposite direction, before meeting same time and after meeting T1 and T2, ratio of speed is under root of inverse of time using it.
So what all we get?
3 is 2.
Now before we start with the question, let's derive something. Let's say one train starts with speed S1 at some time. Other train starts with speed S2 at some other time. So obviously they will meet somewhere in between. So whenever they meet, let's say first train has traveled for T1 hours. Second train has traveled for T2 hours. Means before meeting, time is different as starting time is different. But now, after meeting, they reach the destination at same time. Let's say this is going from A to B and this is going from B to A. So if final reaching time is same after meeting, it's same time. Let's quickly check out what we did. Two trains started at different time. They started at different time. They crossed somewhere in between. So obviously before meeting, time is different. Let's say first train has traveled for T1 hours, second train has traveled for T2 hours. Now, final reaching time is same, it's given. Destination they reach at same time, means after meeting, it's same time. So now, this distance will be S1 T1, and this distance is S2 T2. Now, as it's given, reaching time is same. After meeting, first train has to go S2 T2 distance with speed S1. And after meeting, second train has to go S1 T1 and its speed is S2. This time and this time is same. After meeting, first train has to go S2 T2 with speed S1. Second train has to go S1 T1 with speed S2. So what all we get? And after meeting, timings are same. So we get S2 square upon S1 square is equal to T1 by T2. Or we can say S1 by S2 is under root of T2. So previous case and this case both are same. Previous case was before meeting same time and after meeting different. Now is before meeting, this has traveled for T1 hours, this has traveled for T2 hours. Before meeting different times, T1 hours and T2 hours, distances are S1 T1, speed into time, S2 T2. They reach the destination at the same time, means it's given after meeting, first train has to go S2 T2 with speed S1. Second train has to go S1 T1 with speed S2 and both the times are same. This time and this time both are same. Now if it's same time, what we get here is, so simply, if before meeting same time and after meeting different, or before meeting different time and after meeting same, in any case, ratio of speed is under root of T2 by T1. Now, the question given says, two stations, one train starts at 12 o'clock, other starts at 2 o'clock. Now, they meet somewhere in between at 4 o'clock and 5 o'clock. Let's say speed of this train is S1, this train is S2. Before meeting, this has traveled for 4 hours, 5 minutes. This has traveled for 2 hours, 5 minutes. So before meeting, this time is 245 minutes. This time is 125 minutes. Before meeting, first train has travelled for 4 hours and 5 minutes. Second train has travelled for 2 hours and 5 minutes. Final reaching is same time. So ratio of speed S1 by S2 is under root of T2 by T1. Both can be divided by 5. So we get dividing by 5, 25 by 49. So ratio of the speeds of the two trains is 5:7. Simply what we did. One train starts at 12 o'clock with speed S1. Other train starts at 2 o'clock with speed S2. They meet in between at 4:05. So before meeting, this time T1 is 4 hours 5 minutes. This time T2 is 2 hours 5 minutes. So after meeting in between, first train has to travel 245 minutes, second train has traveled for 125 minutes. They reach at same time, means after meeting this time and this time is same. So ratio of speed is under root of T2 by T1. So that is 125 upon 245. T2 upon T1 dividing by 5. So ratio of speeds of the two trains, we got 5:7. So the complete journey Pune to Nagpur and Nagpur to Pune, complete journey time ratio is going to be 7:5. If speed ratio of the two trains we got 5:7, if distance is same, time ratio will be 7:5. Pune Nagpur, Nagpur Pune, distance is same. So complete journey ratio of time will be 7:5. Now, as one started at 12, other started at 2, but reaching time is same. Starting time difference is of 2 hours. Reaching time is same. So difference in the traveling time is also 2 hours. Simply what I said here is, if one starts at 10 and reaches at 5, other starts at 12 and reaches at 5. Starting, this has traveled for 7 hours, this has traveled for 5 hours. So obviously if this has traveled for T, this is for T minus 2. Because if this starts at 10, this starts at 12, starting time difference 2 hours, so traveling time also difference is of 2 hours. One started at 12, other started at 2, reaching time is same, so traveling time difference is of 2 hours. So simply, if first started at 12, second started at 2, if first needs T hours, second train needs T minus 2 hours. We got ratio of speeds of the two trains 5:7. So time ratio is 7:5. Complete journey A to B, B to A, time ratio. Starting time difference 2 hours. So what all we get here? 5T equal to 7T minus 40. So first train will need 7 hours. So that is at 12 o'clock it starts. 7 hours it needs. So it will reach at 7. This starts at 2. Needs 5 hours. Reaches at 7. A quick recall what I'll be doing. Two things going in the opposite direction, speed S1 and S2. Before meeting, they started at different time. Before meeting T1 hours, before meeting T2 hours. After meeting, time is same, it's given. So S1 T1 distance, it has to go. First train has to go S2 T2 after meeting with speed S1. Second has to go S1 T1 with speed S2. So ratio of speed is under root of inverse of time. Before meeting same time, after meeting different, or before meeting different and after meeting same, in any case, ratio of speed is under root of inverse of time. Using that, one train started at 12, other at 2. Means starting time difference is of 2 hours. Reaching time same. So traveling time difference is of 2 hours. One starts at 12, other starts at 2, they meet at 4:05. So before meeting, 2 hours, 4 hours, 5 minutes, 2 hours, 5 minutes. Reaching time same. So ratio of speed under root of inverse of time. So ratio of speed is 5:7. Complete journey Pune to Nagpur, Nagpur to Pune. Speed ratio 5:7. So time ratio 7:5. Now, this train started at 12, this at 2, reaching time is same, speed ratio 5:7, so time ratio 7:5, starting time difference is of 2 hours, so travelling time difference is also of 2 hours, so it first needed T hours to reach the destination, second needs T minus 2 hours, ratio is 7:5. So T is 7 hours. First train will need 7 hours to reach here, that is 7 o'clock. Second train will need 5 hours to reach here, 7 o'clock. So at 7 p.m. the two trains will meet. At 7 p.m. they will reach the destination.